Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. Today's topic is Mechanism of Hormone Action. Mechanism of Hormone Action. Hormones can be divided into different categories on the basis of the chemical nature. First, the peptide, polypeptide and protein hormones like insulin, glucagon, pituitary hormone, hypothalamic hormones. Second, the steroids, which include cortisol, testosterone, estrogen, and progesterone. Iodothyronines, or the thyroid hormones. And fourth, amino acid derivatives like the epinephrine. Hormone action can be divided into two types: the non-steroid and the steroid types. Now, non-steroid hormones are modified amino acids, peptides and protein hormones, while the steroid ones are the lipid-soluble hormones. Non-steroid hormones are water-soluble and hence lipid-insoluble. As they are lipid-insoluble, they cannot pass through the cell membrane. Hence, they act through the second messengers. While steroid hormones are lipid soluble and they can pass through the cell membrane and hence they directly enter the cell. The only exception being thyroid hormones, which are amine derivatives but are lipid soluble. We'll start with non-steroid hormone action. Now, these hormones produce the effect on target tissues by binding to the receptors. Now, the receptors are extracellular or surface receptors. That means they are present on the cell membrane. Now, these receptors are protein molecules specific for a hormone. The hormone binds to the receptor, forming hormone receptor complex. The hormones are not able to enter the target cell, hence they generate second messengers that regulate the cellular metabolism. Second messengers are cyclic AMP, calcium ions, inositol triphosphate. Now, second messengers are just like mobile phones. Now, mobile phones allow two persons to interact who are not near each other. So, second messengers act as mobile phone interacting between the hormones and the cell. They carry the information from the hormones and transfer it into the cell. In non-steroid hormone action, receptor molecules, G proteins and adenyl cyclase take part. They are present in the cell membrane. Receptors are protein molecules specific for the hormone. G proteins, as the name shows, are associated with guanosine, and attached to the G protein is GDP. Now, when the hormone comes in contact with the receptor, a complex is formed due to which a shape change occurs and the complex comes in contact with G protein. As the complex comes in contact with G protein, it gets activated, changing GDP to GTP. The GTP containing G protein then interacts with adenyl cyclase, activating it. As a result, ATP gets converted into cyclic AMP. The cyclic AMP then activates the kinase protein, which then triggers intracellular changes that causes enzyme activation, secretion, ion channel changes. Single activation produces a lot of cyclic AMP. This is known as signal amplification, which means the hormones are used or required in very less amounts. Now, next, the steroid hormone action. These hormones diffuse through the cell membrane of target cell as they are lipid soluble. So the receptors are intracellular. They either enter the cytoplasm or directly they enter into the nucleus. Now in the cytoplasm or in the nucleus, they form a complex with the receptor. The complex binds to chromosomes, activating certain genes. They then affect either transcription or translation of proteins activated by the hormones. Actions of such hormones are slower and last longer. Thank you. Thank you for watching.